Our visit to Burma was to see for ourselves what the government of Nigeria, the Borno State government, with the support of the UN system, has achieved over the last year or two, and then what the challenges are going forward. What are those gaps that we need to address? To hear from those that are working on the front line, our humanitarian workers, our agencies, our programs, our funds, the people in the state government and of the federal government programs, to visit the camps, the IDP camp, to speak with NGOs, both at the level of the international community, right down to those that are working here, to speak with the theater commander, those that were right on the front lines, to understand better how we can address situations of access to ensure we have everyone so that we save all lives, but also how we deal with maintaining the crisis and working towards exiting to a reintegration of all those that are displaced into their communities. We'd like to take the opportunity to thank the government of Borno State, the leadership of His Excellency, the governor of Borno State, in really moving so fast. The last time I was here, just over 2 years ago, there's considerable improvement in what has happened. Certainly, more can be done, and that's why we're here. We're facing a number of challenges going forward. This is a season where activity can become more pronounced. Everyone needs to be reinforced with the services and the goods that they need to ensure communities are held. We know that we also have the honor of having the Minister of State for Budget and Planning with us. Certainly the plan for the humanitarian response will be one that builds on what we have had before, particularly as the Nigeria has been one of the best resourced from the Oslo meeting that you led with the government of Nigeria for funding, which was over $900,000. I understand that that has been well spent. We have seen the benefits of it. We will look forward to having another opportunity to bring in more funds. We know that there are challenges of the upcoming election, which we would like to be done in a peaceful manner. This is a right of every Nigerian, and that includes the people of Borno State. And so preparing for that is also important. Preparing for the returnees is important. And we see that there are many challenges there that need to be addressed. We thank you for giving us the opportunity, and that of my team. We visited many hubs of the humanitarian community here in Meduguri, in Burma. We understand that more will be put in place so that our workers can go to a place where they work together, coordinated, coherently, and safely to support the people of Borno State.
Excellency, no amount of words can adequately convey the depth of our gratitude for the immeasurable and consistent empathy for the government and people of Borno State. In your different but progressive capacities in the past nearly a decade, we have been privileged to benefit from your value added duties. You are here in your private capacity even before your appointment as an advisor to the former U.S. Secretary General. When I lost my deputy governor, you drove all the way by road from Gombe to my duty to condole us over the sad demise of my deputy governor. You are here as the leader of the federal government delegation to Chibok. We drove in the same car to Chibok. And you are here as the designated deputy secretary general of the United Nations when we went to Burma in 2016. And today you are with us a substantive, productive, and powerful Deputy Secretary General of the United Nations. I must say that in all your abilities, the people of Borno State have continuously gained and benefited from your abilities. And as the Chief Executive of the State, I have personally benefited and still benefiting from your versatile knowledge, your ruggedness, and your uncommon wisdom in the management of complex situations. I remember in the year 2015, at a function in Abuja organized by the Federal Ministry of Environment, the DSG told the gathering that working with us as honorary advisor was one of our most cherished moments. On the contrary, I must admit that it was a privilege for me to have been advised by a woman who is class competent in every aspect of environmental leadership. Working with the DLD is a thing of pride for me. He has contributed so much in shaping the priorities of our administration. And as DLG, our passion for Borno has multiplied. She's a daughter of Borno. She had her formative years here in Maiduguri. She attended Shehu Garbai Primary School. So we can proudly call her our own. We can comfortably compete with Bombay and Kaduna. While we cannot thank the DLG enough, we must acknowledge that whatever passion she has for Borno, what hardly made much impact without the political will of her boss, the UN Secretary General. I'd like to salute the wisdom of the Secretary General for identifying one of our best talents on earth to start as his DSG. We must give it to the UN Secretary General for supporting Mrs. Amina Mohammed. We must also congratulate the world for having Amina in the position to contribute her wealth of experience to improving world peace, social justice, and prosperity. I would like to express our gratitude to the entire family of the United Nations. On particular note, I thank coordinators and officials of the UN Office of Coordination of Humanitarian Affairs, officials of the World Food Program, the UNHCR, UNICEF, UNFPA, IOM, and all other organs of the UN that have been playing very critical roles in supporting our traumatized people, in standing by the Nigerian government, and in standing with our administration through thick and thin. Here, Mr. Edward Kalon has been here so many times. We have gone round the fields with him. Tito, I met him. I think Ms. Kaula, she was here on several occasions, but unfortunately we were able to meet only yesterday. And Crispin Rokasha. You know, we have even developed some relationship. We became friends. And there's one lady, Your Excellency, my in Abuja, her name is DM Keita. She's a wonderful lady. She's in charge of UNFPA. She has been quite helpful in mobilizing funds and resources for the people of Borno. We want you to thank them most sincerely from the bottom of our hearts. And it has to start from their head, Mr. Edward Kalon. Because when a fish starts getting rotten, it starts from the head. So we have to give it to him that he has done his best to promote the interests of the people of this nation. I want to thank the Honorable Minister. He's one minister who has been here more than most other ministers in the Federation. This is about her seventh visit to Borno in the past 3 years. There was a time she came with the UN delegation for the one-day visit. She was forced to spend the night, and she willingly did so without any hurdles. We went to Burma with her. This is her third visit to Burma. And from Burma, we tore the Sambisa apart and went to Chibok, right through the heart of the Sambisa Forest. She's a lady of uncommon courage and commitment, and of course of integrity. She was a native, and she did wonderfully well. Honorable Minister, with our most respects.